The lesson is marginal costing. Here we have to calculate some entries. The number one is contribution. Contribution is the term used to describe the difference between the sales revenue and variable cost. Here we can calculate the contribution in unit wise and as a total. So if they ask in the question unit contribution, this is the way that we have to calculate. Unit contribution equals unit selling price minus variable cost. Total contribution equals total sales minus total variable cost. So total sales quantity in the unit selling price, whereas total variable cost you can calculate quantity into unit variable cost. Or there is another way that you can calculate the total contribution, that is quantity into unit contribution. So you can use either format to calculate the total contribution. Here I have given an equation, sales equals cost plus profit. Always when you are calculating the selling price, we are adding some sort of a profit to the cost. Now because of this, you know, cost can be divided into two, fixed cost and variable cost. So here we can write equation like this: sales equals fixed cost plus variable cost plus profit. If I take the variable cost to the other side, my equation will be sales minus variable cost equals fixed cost plus profit. Since we have done the total contribution term from the sales, when you minus variable cost, you call it as total contribution. So again, we can write the equation total contribution equals fixed cost plus profit. Therefore, to calculate the profit from the total contribution, we have to deduct fixed cost. Question number one. Selling price of a particular product is 100 rupees, unit variable cost is 60, annual fixed cost is 100,000 rupees. If they decided to produce 10,000 units for the year, calculate unit contribution and contribution, total contribution and profit. Unit contribution equals unit selling price minus unit variable cost, which is 100 minus 60. 40 rupees. B part, I told you, you all can use either format. So I have given here both format. Answer will be the same. Total contribution equals quantity into unit contribution. Quantity they have given 10,000 and unit contribution you have already calculated 40. So total contribution is 400,000 rupees. Or you can use the other equation, total contribution equals total sales minus total variable cost. To get the total sales, you have to multiply quantity into selling price. To get the total variable cost, you have to multiply 10,000, which is a quantity, into unit variable cost. When you do the simplification, you get again 400,000 rupees. C part, to calculate the profit. Profit equals total contribution minus fixed cost. 400,000 minus 100,000 equals to 300,000. Second one is to calculate the contribution to sales ratio. We call it as CS ratio. So here I have given so many equations. According to the situation, the question given, you have to adjust yourself. CS ratio equals unit contribution divided by unit selling price into 100. Or if you have the total contribution and total sales, you can use this equation. CS ratio equals total contribution divided by total sales into 100. So when you want to calculate the total contribution, it's just the cross multiplication. Total sales into CS ratio. Or if they have given 2 years profit, 2 years sales, So the change is the difference between those 2 years. Again, you can calculate the same thing. CS ratio equals change in profit divided by change in sales into 100. To get the change, there should be 2 years. Here I have given the question number 2. 4 levels of sales of a particular organization are given below. A 1 million, B 500,000, C 250,000 and D 100,000. CS ratio is 40%, annual fixed cost is 100,000. Find the total contribution and profit or loss for each level. So here I have written the equation to calculate the total contribution if they have given the CS ratio. So the equation is total sales into CS ratio. Profit or loss we can calculate from the total contribution. We are deducting total fixed cost. So when it comes to A level, 1 million is the total sales into 40%, your total contribution is 400,000. 400,000 minus 100,000, which is the total fixed cost, equals profit of 300,000. Just like the same way when we are calculating for each and every level, but when you're looking at the C level, you can see your total contribution also 100,000, whereas your total fixed cost also 100,000. So this is the place where you have neither the profit nor a loss. So this is the situation we call there's a break even. Break even means your total sales is equal to your total cost. So whenever total sales equals to total cost, the intersecting point is called the break even. At that moment, there's no profit, no loss. So the third method, third part is break even analysis. It is an analytical technique for studying the relations among fixed cost, variable cost and profits. In other words, break even analysis is a formal profit planning approach based on established relations between costs and revenues. Break-even point is a technique which uses cost behavior theory to identify the activity level at which there is neither a profit nor a loss. It denotes activity level at which the total cost equals to total sales revenue. When we are doing the break-even analysis, there are three assumptions that we have to make. One is unit selling price is constant. Second one is unit variable cost is constant. Third one is total fixed cost is constant. So these are the three assumptions that we have to make when we are doing the break-even analysis. Now, according to this question, we said the output units, we can produce up to 25,000 units, whereas your income, you can go for up to 10,000 units, 10,000 rupees. So here, margin of safety is the difference between those two. Break even units 10,000, but you can go for 25,000 units. Here, the difference between these two, it's called margin of safety in units. So 25,000 minus 10,000, your margin of safety in units will be 15,000 units. The difference between actual sales units minus break-even units. That is margin of safety units. You can see the graph. If you produce more than break-even and less than 25,000, you can get profit. That's called the margin of safety. So in the question, if they ask to mark the margin of safety in rupee, that is this side. Break even 4,000, but you can go for 10,000 rupees. The difference between 10,000 and 4,000 is your margin of safety rupee. According to this question, 10,000 minus 4,000, your margin of safety is 6,000 rupees. Again, in this
particular part, you can see there's a profit. So if you produce more than 10,000 and less than 25,000, you are in a position to get profit. That's called the margin of safety. So that's a method, whereas to calculate it, margin of safety units equals sales, that is the number of units, minus break even units. When it comes to margin of safety rupees, the value, sales value minus break even sales value, or because you know the margin of safety units, you can multiply it by selling price, again you get the margin of safety value. Last part in marginal costing is income statement. So here, to get the sales, what we are doing here is quantity into selling price, you can get the sales, minus total variable cost, again quantity into variable cost per unit. When you simplify, the answer is total contribution. So here I have given, again you can calculate it like this, quantity into unit contribution. From the total contribution, when you deduct total fixed cost, you get the profit. In a question, if they ask the quantity, this quantity, this is the way you can calculate it. Number of units sold, they're asking the quantity. Expected profit, this is your expected profit, plus fixed cost, you get the total contribution. So expected profit plus fixed cost is the total contribution. Total contribution divided by unit contribution, you get the quantity. So everywhere the quantity is the same. So from this equation, you can get the total contribution, divided it by unit contribution, you get the quantity. Fixed cost they have given as 40,000, divided by unit contribution is 8. Break even units 5,000. Since you calculated break even units, when they ask break even rupee or the value, break even units into selling price, 5,000 into 20 rupee, 100,000 rupees. 100,000 rupees. Margin of safety in units, this is actual sales in units minus break even. 7,000 minus 5,000, 2,000 units. The difference between actual sales and break even sales, units. On the other side, I have given margin of safety in rupees. Since you all have calculated margin of safety units multiplied by selling price, you can get the value. Here 40,000 rupees. Last part, they are asking number of units sold, which is a quantity. Expected profit plus fixed cost divided by unit contribution. Expected profit 20,000. Fixed cost 40,000 divided by 8, number of units sold 7,500 units. 7,500 units. Same here, unit selling price is given, direct cost per unit, no matter they have given raw material, labor, expenses, the addition of these three is called the direct cost. Remember, another name for variable cost is the direct cost. So here the direct cost or the variable cost is addition of 150, 450, which is 600 rupees. Here are the answers. Unit contribution equals unit selling price minus unit variable cost. 800 minus 600 equals 200 rupees. By using that, we are calculating the total contribution. quantity into unit contribution. So total contribution is 600,000 rupees. B part, CS ratio, that is unit contribution divided by unit selling price. 200 divided by 800 multiplied by 100, you get 25%. So it's a ratio, so you have to show it as a percentage. C part, break even units, total fixed cost divided by unit contribution. 400,000 divided by 200, you get number of units 2000. With the use of break even units, we can calculate the break even rupees, break even units into selling price. 2000 into 800, you get a value of 1,600,000. 1,600,000. D part, profit or loss, how to calculate it? Total contribution minus fixed cost. Total contribution we already calculated 600,000. Fixed cost already given in the question 400,000. So there will be a profit of 200,000. Margin of safety in units, current sales units minus break-even units. 3,000 minus 2,000, 1,000 units. By using this, we can calculate margin of safety value. Margin of safety units into selling price, you get the margin of safety value 800,000 rupees. Number of units sold equals expected profit plus fixed cost divided by unit contribution. In this part, they are asking how much is the expected profit if you are going to sell 3,500 units. So when you substitute this, 3,500 equals expected profit plus 400,000 divided by 200. Just do the cross multiplication, 3,500 into 200. You get 700,000 minus fixed cost 400,000. Expected profit is 300,000 rupees. Expected profit is 300,000 rupees.